Hello, and welcome to Mr. Barton's autograph video number 21. Now this week we're going to continue our voyage through the world of circle theorems by looking at our third one, which is angles in the same segment. Now I've set up my page similar to how we've looked at in previous weeks, so you just need a circle with four points and line segments joined up as I've shown you. And what I'm going to do before anything else is going to respond to a few emails that have been flying in over the past couple of weeks saying, how do I get my labels on my points looking so nice? Well, let me show you. Okay, if you highlight a point and you just click on text box, and again, we're just going to get rid of this remove object text and we're going to just change that to A. If you have a little mess around down here, now autograph defaults everything to this ice blue, which is the one you're probably used to, which is brilliant. But I fancy something a bit simpler than that, so I've changed my colour to purple, my size to, my font style to regular, my size to 16. I've also gone to edit frame and I've clicked no border there. And crucially, I've also clicked set as default. Now what that means is that when I click OK and I do this on another point, every single one of my points from now on is labelled in the same nice clear way. So that might be something you might want to do. So I'm just going to very, very quickly label these A, B, C. And let's chuck a D into the mix down there. Remove object text and D. Nice. Okay. Now, angle in the same segment. So I would set something like this up for the student and say to the students, would anybody like to predict what two angles might be the same on this? And it's quite an easy one to spot this, but don't worry, there's a bit more to come. I'm going to chuck a little twist into the mix in a second. So let's build up the tension as much as we can. Let's measure angle A to D to B. Selected three points. I was holding down shift there because I'm in non-whiteboard mode. Right click, and down the bottom we've got angle. And just to build up the tension, I'll get rid of show label. I'll get that to no DP, and I'll get a nice big fat arc size of 12. Click OK. Nice. And then I'll also measure angle A to C to B. Again, holding down shift. Angle, zero decimal places. 12, get rid of show label, there we go. Do the students think these two might be the same size? Well, let's have a little look. Double click on my angle, show label, that's 48 degrees. Double click, show label, and that's 48 degrees. Now what's nice about this is you can emphasize to the students why this theorem actually has the name it has. You've got a chord here, A to B, which splits the circle up into two segments, the minor and the major, and as long as the chord forms an angle, I think subtend, I think is the posh word for that one, anywhere in the same segment, then those angles will always, always, always be the same. And what's nice is as soon as you try and mess that up and dip around over here, they're not the same. But of course, they do have a link between them, the size of those two angles, and that's a theorem that we looked at a couple of weeks ago, the cyclic quadrilateral theorem, so that links that together nicely. But as long as they're in the same segment, then those two angles will always, always, always be the same. But I thought I'd leave you with a little kind of thought exercise and something you can try on your students. Just looking at the screen as it is, I'm going to actually add another line segment to join C to D. So I've just held down shift, clicked on both those points and line segment. And I'd like to picture what you think shape I would form if I was to move these points around so that that blue line, the line A to C, and that yellow line, the line B to D, were to cross through the centre of the circle. What quadrilateral would I form around the outside? And crucially, and this is the key point, how could you prove that that quadrilateral is the quadrilateral that you claim it is without measuring any angles or sides? And that relies on a bit of knowledge about circles and also links nicely into one of the theorems we looked at a couple of weeks ago. There's something for you to think about anyway. Hope all's well with everybody. Remember, email in if you've got any suggestions or comments or topics or even something nice to say. That's always good to hear. Take care, everybody, and I shall see you next week. Bye-bye.